When a patient comes to the office with either a thyroid nodule or thyroid cancer, the first thing to do is to gather all the information to make sure we have everything available. If there is no diagnosis and they're just presenting with a nodule, obviously the first thing to do is to do a fine needle aspiration or a biopsy to diagnose what kind of nodule that is or if there's a cancerous process in it. If a patient does have a cancer who has come in with that diagnosis, then we need to get all the information from the patient in terms of imaging studies, ultrasound, CAT scans or MRIs, as well as pathology reports to review it to decide what needs to be done next. Blood tests are also important to see before the surgery so that we can ensure that the patient is ready for the procedure. Once we've made all the appropriate diagnoses and we've gathered all that information, then we will decide what kind of surgery needs to be done in terms of a hemithyroidectomy or removing half of the thyroid, a total, which is removing the whole thing, or removing the lymph nodes in and around that area as well. Recovery from thyroid surgery is much easier because the surgery is not traumatic. It isn't on an internal organ that works on a daily basis with us. So patients immediately start to speak, eat, walk around, and be able to function fairly well. For the first week to 10 days, they're oftentimes very tired and fatigued because they're using all their resources to heal from the surgery. But after that, their energy level comes back to close to normal. The close follow-up is really required with their doctors to make sure that their thyroid hormone levels are at an appropriate level and their future plans in terms of radiation therapy or iodine therapy is scheduled.